How's it going, Yuka? Yeah, I had all sorts of cool tokens I wanted to take to the GP. I had like pretty Thopters from Isle of Cards. I can link you that. If anybody is looking to play Thopter Blade, use these Thopter tokens. They're sexy. I gave some away at the GP for freebies to some people. Next stop, Community Cup. What? What's the win condition? Card advantage, birds, planeswalkers. Green screen's not happy, says Tom. Let me see. No, it's just the lighting's changed. I mean, I could mess with it, Tom, if you really want me to. Maybe just reset the color. Maybe that's a little bit better. It's not been happy with me lately, to be honest, friend. For my local, nice. Yeah, company suite. But that's not a dumb question, Sprite Star. Hell, Sprite Star, when I played Blue Red Control like 3 years ago, 3 years ago, 3 or 4 years ago, I would just win with Colonnades and Snapcasters and Burn, and then maybe sideboard into some Walkers. That's about it. Mean, if you're not comfortable playing a long game of Magic and, getting those win conditions after stabilization, I don't think Blue Red's really the deck for you. The last time I played Lantern on Magic Online, I won Cadrill, but he timed out, so I don't know how it would be in paper. I actually didn't play the match at the GP. How strong I think Commandeers is a sideboard? I think it's good when there's a lot of Tron. I did beat somebody at the GP with the Commandeer one of the few times I brought it in. There were a couple matches I brought it in. Brought it in against Burn, believe it or not. And I used it. I rolled out of Standard last year, got tired having to chase so many cards. I don't blame you, King Cars. Where are you going now? Oh, yeah, you're the guy playing Nye Company. Good choice. Hey, my opponent might like have disconnected or something, and I'm starving. Let me grab something. I'll be right back. Yeah, my opponent disconnected. So I'm gonna bring up the deck list, give you guys something cool to look at, but I am gonna go get something to eat if we're gonna keep this stream going because I am starving. And you guys feel free to do the same. In the meantime, do 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 do. A little bit of Sandstorm for you guys to listen to. I'll be right back, guys. Don't go away. Seriously, like 2 minutes. Let's go into the fridge. Quick, He's gone. Spam emojis. I see what you're doing. I was on my phone. You guys are just ridiculous. Ridiculous. I mean, I should totally like time all of you out, right? I'm just kidding. That's fine. I know Sandstorm brings out the best in the Twitch community. Doesn't it, guys? Ooh. Hydration. Gabriel says, sorry, my fault. Oh, is he back, my opponent? Is he done being disconnected? I think he's back. He's back. It's all good. I went to warm up some food. It's all good. I waited for you. Sandwich. Meatball sandwich. Quite. I'm not opposed to colonnade. I mean, I jam colonnade for years, so I'm not opposed to it, but I don't think we necessarily need it. Yeah. That could be coaxed. The dredge deck is sweet, Kadro. Brew, brain, draw, restore balance. That actually would work on Magic Online, which is tempting, Rayolin. And then the cool thing is you're a restore balance deck that doesn't have to run the same mana base. As the That's true. Yeah, I mean that has a lot of potential because like, restore balance has a lot of strength. Oh, tomato. What am I not that excited about? I mean, the surgical suite if I get to hit a Tron land with a Ghost Quarter. Maybe that's a pipe dream at this point. Maybe we just need to keep all the permission. For example, resolving the Tamio against my blue Tron opponent is also a pipe dream. And we do the brain. Okay, so we cast it, and then all we have left is a lodging knot and a snare. Let's see what he's got. Sign asks, what does snare even hit? Oh, they run romance. There are other targets, but those are the big ones. Sometimes Blutron will run Snapcaster Mage. Yeah, brain could cast Restore Balance. Ray says you can sac Restore Balance to. Oh my goodness. Speaking of spell snare, he's spell snaring mine. It's fine. That's one spell snare down. Alright, worm coil. So he has 1, 2, 3 mana. So this is actually good enough. So did my math wrong. Yep, Condescend for Axis 2. Can't spell snare that. So that does mean the coil's gonna enter the play. Unfortunately, we didn't have the remand ready to go. Okay, so we countered the brain, so we can't set up the Beck Call, unfortunately. But I could Cryptic Bounce this Worm Coil and try to set something up. We left in the paths, right? Yes, we did. So. There's the brain, but no land to play it. Well, I mean, if we drew land, then yeah, it makes. You understand what I'm trying to say there. Like, if we drew the brain, we don't have the land to play it. If we draw the land, we don't have the... Ooh, geez, speaking of losing lands, we'll lose three here. Island, mountain, plains.
Oh, yeah.
How to get rug assault end up going. Akira was great. The get rug deck was fantastic, actually. I was gonna be left with like nothing. Yeah, I just didn't get anything going. That's okay. I mean, my assumption is without the boom busts, seriously, anytime we play against Tron, there's really little I can do. And maybe the Tron decks are popular right now because people want to jam the Nahiri nonsense. Alright, hang on a second. Actually, before we queue again, I am going to get that food because I'm hungry. And you are probably going to be hungry too in a second here. I'm going to keep the cam off though because I know some people don't like to watch other people eat, and that is reasonable. Yeah, the Gitrog deck though, Kira, was great. The infinite Gitrog seismic kill was a lot of fun. Pretty robust deck. Probably warm this up too much. I can't even hold the plate. Yeah, probably did. But yeah, like I guess what's nice is like I mean we already took it to the GP, already did what we wanted to do with the deck, so it's fine if it doesn't work on Magic Online. That doesn't disappoint me. This is not what I took to the GP though. I took a different variant of it. But. It doesn't bother me, and a lot of that, you know, a lot of players, like, I think the number one thing that prevents a lot of people from brewing or brewing at all or enhancing a brew or keeping up with a brew and tweaking, making the appropriate changes. And this is something I touched on with you guys time and time again, but this is the scientific brewing process. When you, let's try to get in on that. When you have a brew that you believe in, and this one did do well, what needs to happen now is, it's actually totally out of my hands. So what needs to happen now with the Brain in a Jar deck isn't me necessarily playing it anymore, although I mean how it works. What needs to happen now is this. So I observed a metagame, I hypothesized, I experimented with the deck and took it to a GP. Day-tuned with it, and now we need to have the refining happen. So now what needs to happen is where you guys take the deck and you guys do your own thing with Brain in a Jar, whether it's Beck and Boom Bust or some of the other few spells we looked at. I don't know. You guys are going to have to take it to the next level because there's really only so much I can do with the Brain in a Jar deck, especially since I actually mailed the cards back just today. So I actually don't own the deck anymore except for on Magic Online, but here it doesn't even work. So, oh, good luck, have fun. It's kind of up to you guys now, you know? And I have faith that, you know, some of you guys will figure it out and the next evolution of brain decks will happen. It'll be fun. Yeah. Sean tried his best. What? I'm actually going to go Strand. Oh, I didn't.